Yes, I did cap with my brokerage. So this house is listed for $1,850,000. I have an Ulta haul for you.
Are you gonna be a big old dog? Oh my goodness.
I made it to my open house here in Longboat Key. Let's go check it out. Hello, my friends. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I know that my YouTube schedule's kind of, and I wouldn't really call it a schedule. It's just kind of whenever I feel like taking out my camera, I bring it out. Welcome back. Today, this video is probably just a bunch of clips all in one. I have an open house today. It is Sunday. You guys know what we do here on Sundays. I say it every video. Open house Sundays. I actually took a step back from open houses just because life got a little crazy, a little hectic. Springtime for us is super busy. Our weekends are full of anniversaries, birthdays, holidays, all of that. So the past couple of weeks, I haven't been able to get inside an open house. My team just so happens to have a beautiful listing right on Longboat Key. And I saw it immediately on our little open house tracker. I said, this is the one, I wanna go in that one. So I'm gonna bring you guys along with me today. I just wanted to bring my camera out and talk to you guys and update you guys because so many new things have happened and life is good, business is really good, and I'm just very thankful over here. Yeah, I have a lot of things to update you guys on. One of them being makeup related. And I know some of you guys are like, yes, bring it back. And then another part of me is like, I don't know anything anymore. I'm definitely out of the makeup game, but I got some new products. You've been watching me for a while. You guys know I've been on a no-buy for, I don't know, like 6 years at this point. I can officially say that my no-buy is over, not because I want it to be, just for the safety of my face. It's over. I had something happen on my face and it lasted about a month. Very painful, and it was pretty much all over my eye area, underneath my eye, mainly sat like right under this eye. My skin was raw, it was burning, it was on fire every day. And I came to a conclusion that it was my makeup brushes. We are throwing everything I own away. I'm kind of upset about it because just some of these brushes I've had for so long and I love them. I just have a mix of like high-end brushes, drugstore brushes, like my Jaclyn brushes. I'm so sad to throw these away, but I know that I need to because literally everything I own makeup related is a lot of years old. Yeah, I'm not even going to dig in here to keep my favorites because I just know that they're really old. So it makes me really sad that I have to do this and then go out and spend a fortune on things, but it is time. So I have an Ulta haul for you. I'm starting to replace my brushes first just to see if that's the problem, which I'm pretty sure it was because my face is completely clear now and I haven't had any reactions. So I thank God it was just, you know, my brushes. I don't know, are you guys like me too? I just cannot throw away my makeup. A lot of it's still really old, but if it's not giving me a reaction, I'm not gonna throw it away, you know? I think I'll slowly start to replace. We all know makeup's so expensive, so to replace a whole makeup collection is so, I want to show you what I replaced my brushes with. I've been eyeing these for a while. Anytime I go into Ulta, I see these and I'm like, ooh. This is the Ariel Morphe collection. And I just thought this was perfect because it had everything I needed. Like, there's truly not one brush in here that I don't need. Powder brush, foundation brush, which I think it's a little too loose to be a foundation brush. So I just have this as like an extra like powder. This for like blush, bronzer. This could be used for blush. It is a little flimsy, so I feel like I have trouble getting the product on it, but it is really light and feathery. I don't know how to explain it. It is a good brush though. And then just the small one for highlighter. It's pretty much all that I need. And then I did go ahead and get a new beauty blender. I got the Morphe one, which I remember it being a little bit more bouncier. I might get the e.l.f. one next. I switch between this one and the e.l.f. one a lot, but these two are my favorite. This one and the e.l.f. And then for eye brushes, I'm very specific when it comes to eye brushes. I need at least two blending brushes, so like a big one and then a little one. And I got some eyebrow brushes, just a staple to have. These are all from Morphe. Oh, sorry, this one's from e.l.f. This one has like the little spatula if you want like the feathery brow look. And then just a smaller dense one for a more detailed look. And I know I just said I didn't pick out my favorites from my other collection. These are about the only two brushes that I kept because I like this brush for blush. I like to have a dense brush. I switched it up a little bit. I still like the feathery one to give a more natural look, but I'm a blush girl, so like packing blush on is really great for like a dense brush like this. This is from Eco Tools. And then this Real Techniques brush is just really good to have for underneath the eyes. I'm so sad. So many of these are my favorite. This Bare Minerals brush is almost $40 and I have to throw it away. I'm so sad. My It Cosmetics brushes. I'm pretty sure it was this that gave me an infection. This is the Ariel Beauty Blender and I don't know. I wash it every single day before I use it and it stinks. So I don't know, I'm pretty sure there's probably mold in this, and I'm pretty sure that's the culprit. So happy to have fresh brushes and just excited to use new things instead of things from a decade ago. Oh, I got this brush too, this little flat brush. I also had to get some cotton pads for like toner and micellar water. I had to stock up on some dry shampoo. I haven't tried the blush from Batiste. I know that I shared in my TikTok that I wasn't a fan of this, but I think that I am. I have a love-hate relationship with this. Don't ask me why, I just do. I also got some rosemary oil. I really love this oil, especially if like you bleach your hair, it's damaged, dry, or especially if you want to grow. This is really great. I put it on my roots, I put it on my ends, and I let it soak all day and then I'll wash it out, but this is also really great. If you guys have damaged hair, this is so good. I got this at Sephora, I didn't get it at Ulta, but while we're talking about oils, I just wanted to share this, the K18 oil. I have no words. And then I got the e.l.f. Power Grip Primer. I've just heard really good things about this. I've used it for the past 3 days, and I really like it. I swear my makeup has lasted so much longer. And then I just stocked up on my Tried and True. This is the lightest shade, but more pinkier toned. This is really great for brightening up your under eye. Yeah. I love that. Is that a house?
Yeah.
I love that.
Yeah, I'm gonna get some in my playroom. I'll be right back.
Okay. All right, that's what I got at Ulta. I just wanted to show you guys because I know you love Ulta hauls and I love them too. I wanted to give a little life update. I wouldn't say little, I'd say it's pretty major for our family. We did get a puppy. We've had her for a while now. I just haven't had time to share anything. I've just been really busy with work. We did get a puppy and we are very happy with her. She's so sweet. We're still working on potty training. She came from a kill shelter in Georgia. And I just fell in love with her when I saw her. I thought that she was the perfect addition to our family. We've had her for quite a while now. I just haven't shared her just because. But yeah, I thought that it would be the perfect addition for our family because Austin works from home now and we still have a toddler. I wouldn't really classify Gray as a toddler anymore. I'd say she's a teenager. I definitely think she's gonna be around like 45 to 50 pounds. And I believe she's got some lab in her for sure. We're not sure. The shelter that we got her from had pretty much no information on her. So we want to get her DNA tested. But she's definitely going to be a big doggo. Are you going to be a big doggo? Are you going to be a big doggy? Are you going to be a big old doggy? Oh my goodness. Are you going to be a big old doggy? So we're very happy to have her and watch her grow. But we still need to work on the potty training, right? Right? I feel like I had a baby all over again. This is no joke. It's no joke. It's no joke. But she's very sweet. And she loves kids, which is perfect for us, so.
Daisy.
made it to the open house here in Longboat Key. The reason I love doing open houses or just showings here in Longboat Key in general is the drive is just so relaxing. You drive right on the side of the coast and it's just so relaxing and the vibes are always really, really great. So it just puts me in like a different mindset than like just driving more inland. I get to look at the beaches and the palm trees and it's just always so beautiful. I actually sold my first luxury condo here in Longboat Key just a couple months ago. So it's definitely a place that I know very well and I cherish very much. And I just love when our team gets listings here because it's an opportunity for, you know, people on the team to come out here and learn about this island. And it's just so, so much fun. And the houses here are stunning. So this house is listed for $1,850,000. And I think that price is really great. You're walking distance from the beach, literally like 2 minutes. You have a canal in the back. You can dock some jet skis. It's a little bit smaller. In order to bring in a boat, you'll probably have to dock it at a marina, which is just down the road, but it can be kind of renovated to fit a boat if needed. It was built in 2002. It's a 4-bed, 3-bath, very spacious, very open. A lot of things were renovated during the past few years, the flooring, the light fixtures, window treatments on all the windows, and the total area of square footage is just shy of 3,500 square feet, which is amazing. So if you need the space, right by the beach, check this house out. I'm gonna give you guys a little tour. In the future, I really want to perfect my house tours, but in the meantime, I just have a little handheld camera, so it's not gonna be like super fancy, but I'm just gonna show you what I see. Yeah, I've already had one family walk through. I don't think it's the house for them because of the boat situation. They have a boat that they need docked at the house, so parking it at the marina for them just isn't ideal. Let's check out the house. Here is the front. Surrounded by palm trees, all of the landscaping is super mature. So that's really nice. I love when I get homes that have, you know, matured landscaping. Here's just a little quick view. I love these doors. Here is a little overview of the entrance. So you have a formal dining area, a little extra living space. Over here is the primary bedroom. And it leads out to the pool area. I'll show you guys this in a sec. I love the primary closets. The closets are both custom. So here's one and the other. And here is the primary bathroom. You've got double vanities. And I love this area right here. You have tons of extra storage. And I love their little ottoman that they put in here. It's so cute. Like I said, this is the formal dining. You have garage in here, laundry, bedroom. This leads across here to the hallway. Bathroom. You have another bedroom. Upstairs. Up here is really fun as well. So you have your other bedroom. Again, this is a 4-bed, 3-bath. Your other bathroom in there. And this is a nice space. You could totally do a lot with this space. Got a little kitchenette up here. I assume they probably used this just as a little gathering room. Would be really nice as a movie room. All right, we're gonna come down here again to the kitchen. One of my favorite areas of the house. This kitchen was recently renovated. I love all of their little coastal touches to the house. It's super cute. And your living space. Okay, really quick, I want to share a little OOTD, just a basic plain navy blue dress and just Just some, it's really basic. Ladies, where are we getting our clothes at nowadays? Because I need clothes that are professional, but also that I can wear on a daily basis. So like if I'm out and about running errands and then, oh, I get a call, I need to do a showing. Like I just wanna be dressed for the entire day. I don't wanna go back home and change. And then that just plays into my time of studying for the property, making sure my buyer is prepped, and then prepping myself. So it's, where are we getting our clothes? Because I'm really struggling not getting everything from Shein because I love Abercrombie, but this dress at Abercrombie would be like $100 or over $100. I really slowly want to start investing into pieces, like timeless classic pieces. Let me know what like little boutiques you guys are shopping at that are like fairly priced. I've checked out Cider. I don't know if you guys are familiar with that, but they pop up on my Facebook ads all the time and I just catch myself scrolling so much. So, Cider's really cute. I don't know if they're like the same with Shein. I have no idea like their background, but yeah, just where are you shopping? Let me know in the comments below where you're getting your professional comfy clothes that lasts a long time rather than, you know, Shein. You know, it is affordable, but it doesn't last that long. I wanna talk about real estate for a minute. If you guys saw on my Instagram, it was, I don't even remember when it was, but I basically was just crying, just saying how thankful that I was and that I had capped with my brokerage being, I think I am 5 or 6 months on my new team. I'm blown away. Like I did not expect, and I don't want to toot my own horn. It's more of a, I'm very proud and I want to say that I'm proud kind of moment. And I want to say it on here because I know that this industry is so discouraging and it's hard. And I just want to say that I see all of you. I see all of you in my messages. I follow so many kick-ass agents on social media that are in the same boat. It is so hard if you don't have a team to back you up with accountability or just a mentor to back you up with that accountability. It's hard to make it on your own. Right now it feels impossible for me to do it alone. I have a huge team behind me and I'm just so thankful for them every single day, truly. I wish I could just make a whole video dedicated to Zargami Group because literally every single person on our team is just amazing inside and out. I wanted to mention that yes, I did cap with my brokerage and it's super exciting because I don't owe that fee anymore and anything I make moving forward, that commission is now mine instead of Keller Williams. So just to have that like extra security knowing whenever I write a contract is just so, you know? Anyways, real estate's just been absolutely amazing. Obviously I have my moments, you know, quiet time, but I feel like it all comes at once. Like I'll say out loud that, oh my gosh, I have nothing in my pipeline for the week or like for months coming, and then it all just whooshes in all at once. Like 2 weeks ago, I was saying out loud like, oh, I need a deal for May, I need a deal for May. And then 2 days later, I got somebody under contract for May. So it's definitely a roller coaster, but I've just been super thankful that I have people to call every day. Yeah, I've been loving real estate. I'm on my, I think my 9th contract for the year. And I feel like at the end of the year, I have a goal. I would like to move 20 families forward this year. And right now I am almost on my 10th contract. So now I have the rest of the year to do 10 more. So I have a goal set in my mind that I'm trying to hit and I'm halfway there. And that's just really crazy to me. With that being said, if you guys are looking for a property here in the Florida area, let me know. I specialize in Southwest Florida, so I know quite a bit over here on this coast. Also, if you're not looking in Florida, if you're looking somewhere else in the US, just let me know. I have resources to find the best agent for you wherever you are. And I think I've sent out probably 7 referrals just this month through social media. So I've found some of you guys, some really great agents. I actually just had somebody reach out through Instagram and they closed last week. So that's really exciting just to know that I'm still moving families forward without being in the contract, you know? I'm about to pack up my open house. It ends in like 30 minutes. I only had one family come in today, which is kind of shocking because usually when I do open houses over here, tons of people come by, even the tourists right down the road. But today we didn't really have anyone. We had one family. They were kind of interested in the house. The boat dock is definitely holding them back from even making an offer. So there's just little things about out, you know, some properties that don't fit well with others. But yeah, only one family. The market is definitely slowing down for the summertime. I feel like it's just summer, people are busy, kiddos are getting out of school, so that definitely halted a lot in the real estate industry. I doubt that this house will be sitting on the market for a long time. It's beautiful in the best location, so I know that there is a buyer for this house out there somewhere. I'm debating on going across the street to check out their private beach access, but I'm hungry and I want to get home. I have to pick up all the open house signs, so I don't know. I'm thinking. Instead of going to the beach, I'm just gonna show you guys the cute houses down the street. Down here is just a dead end. But I kind of want to see the houses on this cul-de-sac down here. Beautiful. This is for sale. The beach is right behind these houses, guys. Ooh, this one's stunning. This is what's at the end of, I thought it was a cul-de-sac down here, but it's just this big, beautiful house. No biggie. I love the blue shutters on this. Something about a white house and blue shutters in like a wood-toned garage to me is so amazing. I think that's my dream home. I don't know. I've seen so many now that my dream home changes pretty much every week. But a big white house, blue shutters right on the coast. This one's cute, this dark green one. And this is the one right across the street from my open house that I just did. Stunning landscaping, love it. My job.